Right before Stephen Hawking passed away, he was working on one last theory about what happened to the universe following the Big Bang. It's been 2 months since Stephen Hawking died, and now his theory, which he co-wrote with Professor Thomas Hertog, was published in the Journal of High Energy Physics. What exactly was this theory? I'll fill you in here on IO. What is happening, people? This is IO, and I'm Charlotte Dobre. Alright, who wants to talk about some physics? Okay, I promise I'll break it down in the simplest terms possible because Hawking's theory really does change everything that was previously assumed by scientists. Stephen Hawking and Professor Thomas Hertog shared a theory known as eternal inflation. For those who are just getting up to speed, following the Big Bang, our universe began to expand at an exponential rate. This is what is known as cosmic inflation. Scientists believe there are parts of our universe that are still expanding due to the Big Bang, but not all parts. The visible universe, for example, everything we can see, is not. Hawking and Hertog do not agree with this. Basically, they argue that the accepted theory of eternal inflation actually conflicts with Einstein's theory of general relativity. Hawking once said in a statement, "The usual theory of eternal inflation predicts that globally, our universe is like an infinite fractal, with a mosaic of different pocket universes, separated by an inflating ocean. We predict that our universe, on the largest scales, is reasonably smooth and globally finite, so it is not a fractal structure." Hawking never really liked the theory of the multiverse. If the scale of different universes in the multiverse is large or infinite, the theory can't really be tested. In their theory, Hawking and Hertog used string theory combined with the holographic principle. They tweaked and tweaked until they were successful. Eternal inflation was transformed into a timeless state with no fractals or multiverses. They also believe that this theory can be tested, which is groundbreaking. The next step is to spot gravitational waves which could essentially prove or disprove their theory of eternal inflation. That was a lot. My brain is overloaded. Let's respond to some comments, shall we? Todd Winthrop said, "I love IO, but not for IO. I love IO because Charlotte is on it. Oh, and the babushka cap. Glad you like my hat. I put it on when I haven't washed my hair. Hey." And also when it rains, because I have frizzy hair and there's honestly no point in doing my hair. Cosia said, "Dobre means good or cool in my language, so Charlotte, you're pretty Dobre. Love all the news." Oh, hey, thanks. Fun fact, I'm also Romanian, so Dobre means good in my language as well. Zephyr Play said, "Woohoo! Charlotte is back." Yes, I am. Playlist Live was awesome. I had like the best time. For those who wanted to see everything that happened, I posted a vlog on my personal channel. A link for that will be down below in the comments. The video is over. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed it, make sure you hit that thumbs up and subscribe to IO for a different take on the news. Do you want to go on an IO binge? Of course you do. There is a playlist right over here that you should check out. Also, we are on social media. We got Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Make sure you scroll down to the description for all of our links. That's all for now. See you in another video.